Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel Tutorials by Nitin. I really hope that you all are doing well. So in today's video, I will tell you the basics tools of Photoshop and how to speed up your Photoshop work with these preferences settings. So without wasting much time, let's jump into the video. Here is our interface of Photoshop, and it's a 2021 version of Photoshop. Okay, now mostly we will work with the help of shortcut keys. So create a new document by pressing Ctrl N. And here you can create document according to your requirement. Here are some presets like photo for photo printing, 3x2 inches, 6x4, 7x5, and so on. And print presets, art and illustration presets, web presets, mobile presets. Here are some mobile dimensions already set to be here as a preset. You can choose your own phone and design your work. So we will create a random document. Create. Now this will create the transparent background, but in case you need to white background, select background content white, and resolution should be, mostly people are confused in resolution. Resolution is the pixels, how many pixels in single inch, 1 inch. Suppose default is 72, this means 72 pixels in 1 inch. Okay, background content white, here is width, here is height, and here is the our unit, pixel, inches, centimeter, millimeters. First go with pixels, create. Now here is our canvas, that is 1920 by 180 pixels. Okay, now the main part is layers. Every work you did in this, you will do in this canvas, this will record as a layers step by step. Suppose I will create text tool, horizontal type tool, just single click and type your text. Select all by Ctrl A and increase the font size. You also use move tool. For using move tool, press V, and for transformation tool, press Ctrl T, or you can also click here, show transformation control, and increase from the corner. And see, here is our new layer, that is Hello World, and T indicates it's a text layer. Okay, now before going to next, we have to change some settings. Go to file, go to edit and preferences, and general. See, here are a lot of settings. First, there is an option auto show the home screen. If we check this option, this will show our recent document screen, and that slow down the process of Photoshop. So I prefer to uncheck this option. And next is interface. You can change your Photoshop interface like this. Currently I'm using the second one. You can change this color according to your desire. Now next is workspace. There is no need to change anything. Tools, yes, in tools you can change zoom with the scroll wheel. If we uncheck this, then you will not able to zoom the document with scroll wheel of mouse, but if you check it, then you will zoom the document with scroll wheel. Now next is history log. No need to change anything. No. Now next is performance. Right. Here is 64 GB RAM is installed in my computer, and Photoshop uses 70% of its total RAM. You should at least 70 to 80% RAM RAM provides to Photoshop for better results or better performance. And if you have a graphic card, so check this, use graphic processor, it will improve your performance. Now here is history states. History state is that is some kind of undo technique, undo how much times you can undo your work by pressing Ctrl Z or by pressing Ctrl Alt Z. So default is 50, we will set it to 100. And next is scratch disk. Scratch disk helps to create a temporary file. Like here is only first drive select C, that is a SSD. If you have not SSD, you can select your both drives to improve your performance. If you have SSD, then select only SSD. Now almost this is done. Hit OK. Now our first tool is Move tool. You can shortcut of Move tool is V. Here you can move your layer content like this, like here, like here, like here, like here, anywhere in the whole document. Okay. This is the Move tool. And now next is selection. Selection tool means you can select the part of the document. And now if you work on any tool, this will, like I am using brush tool. Here is no new layer, so first we have to create a new layer by pressing this plus icon. Now brush tool, decrease the size by using curly brackets, or increase the size by curly brackets. Now see, we will only work in this selection, not outside the selection. So this means selection is the active part of your canvas. I am deselecting this selection by pressing Ctrl D, or you can also deselect the selection by go to select and deselect. Now this is our new layer. Okay, and by holding the mouse left click, you will see different options: rectangular marquee tool, elliptical marquee tool, single row marquee tool, single column marquee tool. Like elliptical marquee tool, create a new layer. By pressing shift, you can control its radius, or not, you can create like a ellipse or your any shape. Got it. Now next is, there is one more option to fill the color in selection. Like I am using elliptical marquee tool, and by pressing shift it looks like a circle. Now I want to fill this circle with the color of foreground. I'm changing the foreground color by pressing single click on this color icon. Like I'm choosing red. Now press Alt Backspace. It will fill your selection part. And if you want to change this background color, now you want to fill blue, that is background color, to fill in this circle, press Ctrl Backspace. This will fill the background color. And if you press Alt Backspace, this will fill the foreground color. So this is the method to fill the foreground color or background color. This is the easiest method. Now next is, if sometime you can change by mistake you have to close these tabs, or you layer sections or channel sections or anything, this is some messy look like, so there is one option here. Click on this small arrow and reset essentials. Reset essentials, your all workspace will be reset to default like this. Now you can change this to double layer mode. So these are our layers, and this is our background. So next is, create a new layer. Here is our brush. You can use as a paint like this, and there are a lot of options we can change in the brush. I am doing the control Z to undo this part. So first select brush tool, right click on, you can change the size of brush. See, you can increase the size of brush. Also you can change the shape like this and this. Also there are a lot of preset brushes you can choose, like this. This is the brush settings. Now this is the basics of brush tool. In future, we will discuss about its settings and how to create your own brush, everything. So this is our basic tools of Photoshop, and here in file section you can create new document, open your any image or open recent document if you have any work, and don't forget to save the document. And most probably, and every time you have to save in PSD format, that is Photoshop document. Rename the file. I am renaming it to firstclass.psd and save it. Hit OK. That's it. Don't forget to save your work. Now in file there are a lot of options: export, generate, and all these options we will learn in future. And in edit section there is cut, copy, paste, fill, everything we will discuss in next class about this menu, file, edit, image, layer. So hope you will enjoy the today's first class. I know I am not perfect in teaching, but I will try to teach you in a easiest way. If you have any query regarding your first class or these tools, you can ask me in comments section. Hit the subscribe button if you have not subscribed it yet. Thank you. Bye. Stay home. Stay safe.